This is part 17 of Blazor tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to implement model validation in an ASP.NET Core REST API. ASP.NET Core provides several built-in attributes for model validation. Required attribute. This attribute specifies a field is required. Range attribute specifies the minimum and maximum allowed value. Min length specifies the minimum length of a string. Max length, maximum length of a string. Compare compares two properties of a model. For example, compare email and confirm email properties. Regular expression validates if the provided value matches the pattern specified by the regular expression. In our solution, the model classes are in this project employee-management.models. To be able to use the built-in validation attributes, we'll have to bring in a NuGet package. Let's do that using Package Manager console. First, select our employee-management.models project from the drop-down list and then execute this command, install package system.componentModel.annotations. There we go, package installation complete. Now, in an ASP.NET Core REST API, to implement model validation, all we have to do is decorate the respective properties of the employee model class with the validation attributes that we have just seen. Now, let's make this first name field a required field. And to do that, all we have to do is decorate this property with the required attribute. Bring in the namespace system.componentModel.dataAnnotations. Let's also make this last name property required. And while we are here, let's also enforce min length validation on first name. We want to ensure first name contains at least a minimum of 2 characters. Let's run our project and quickly test model validation using Postman. I have Postman up and running. Notice we are issuing a post request to our collection URI slash API slash employees. And notice I have deliberately set first name property to just 1 character. Let's remove this last name property as well and then send this request to the server. Request completed. If we take a look at the response we got from the server, notice we got the HTTP status code 400 bad request along with the 2 validation errors. The last name field is required. The field first name must be a string or array type with a minimum length of 2. Now, if you don't like these validation error messages, you can very easily change them using the error message property of the respective validation attribute. Now, if it's an ASP.NET Core MVC web application that you're building, then we explicitly check if model state has succeeded or failed by using modelState.isValid property. In an ASP.NET Core web API project, there is no need to explicitly check modelState.isValid property. Now, if you notice, our employees controller is decorated with API controller attribute. So this attribute takes care of checking if the model state is valid. If it's not valid, it automatically returns the HTTP status code 400 along with the validation errors. Most of our validation requirements can be implemented using these built-in attributes. However, there are few use cases which we cannot implement using these built-in validation attributes. For example, let's say we do not want to allow a new employee to be created if the provided email is already in use. Let's see how to implement this. Now, to be able to check if an employee email address is already in use, I'm going to add a new method to this interface iEmployee repository. It's going to be very similar to this getEmployee method. So let's make a copy of this and then change the bits that are required. First of all, let's change the name of the method to getEmployee by email, and let's pass the employee email as a parameter. Our obvious next step is to provide implementation for this new interface method. It's going to be very similar to this getEmployee method. So let's make a copy of this. And to get the signature right, let's copy the name of the method and the parameter from the interface. Instead of retrieving the employee by employee ID, we now want to retrieve the employee by email. Next, within our employees controller, inside this create employee method before we actually create the new employee, let's check if the provided email is already in use. So for that, let's use the injected employee repository. And on this, we have get employee by email method. So let's retrieve the employee by the provided email. If the variable emp is not equal to null, that means the provided email is already in use and we don't want to proceed with the new employee creation. Instead, we want to return a validation error. For that, all we need to do is on the model state object call add model error method and then provide values for these two parameters. I'm going to set the error key to email and the error message to employee email already in use and then return bad request, passing it the model state object. With all these changes in place, let's run our project and quickly test it using Postman. Notice I've set email to david@pridiumtech.com. This email is already in use. Now let's try to create this employee and see what happens. Request completed, and if we take a look at the response, we got the HTTP status code 400 bad request along with the validation error, employee email already in use. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening. One, two, one, two, one, two.